to make sure we have the most appropriate kind of UI for each kind of workflow. So what does this mean for webmasters and SEO? Put really simply, it's business as usual, right? We want you to keep making really great documents and helping us provide really good answers, right? So that means writing standards compliant HTML, means making sure that the information is available on the page. We have Webmaster Central, we have a variety of blogs where you can read up more on specific tips and tricks. But it's really about providing the best possible information to users in a straightforward and transparent way. And then also, I want to make a big push to encourage you to take advantage of new verticals we're introducing. So for example, providing captions on images or using our sitemap features will allow us to find your content. So every day we're adding a lot more images, a lot more videos, a lot more location information to our indexes through these channels where we intentionally judge webmasters. Local Business Summer, if you want to know how to help things get discovered, it's a really important tool, so use that information all throughout Google. Submitting products to product search through Google Base, that data is also used in a variety of ways across Google. Information is good. It's on the internet. And that's it. I didn't change Jackie's last song, so I should say Francis. She presented my career because I'm awesome. Yeah. Do you have any questions?
I'm really curious how you're going to solve the problem of, like you said, you're comparing apples to oranges, right? So it's search results, like typical web pages versus video versus map, and how you rank those in relevance. It seems to me at this point that the formula may have changed, but it seems that there's a large discrepancy toward video, and sort of the more interactive the piece is, seemingly the higher SERP it's getting, right?
That's not entirely true. So, I'll repeat the question. My apologies. So, he asked, how do we compare those apples to oranges, right? And he gave a specific example of, it seems like the coverage of video has continued to creep up. And he posited that perhaps interactivity is the reason why we choose one thing over another. So one of the things that I really like about working at Google is that, I once heard the line at a conference, that we are all social scientists studying the human condition through the medium of the internet. And at Google, we have a very privileged position on that take, in that we have the ability to access a great deal of how people are looking for information just by the sheer volume of queries that come in. So we do a number of things to try to be rigorous in understanding what users actually want. So we do study extensively the patterns of what users click on. And users do click on videos that are very high rate. So there is a certain degree of interactivity. We also do a variety of other evaluation mechanisms. So we have people who we've trained who sit and actively compare every different ranking domain to the current state to see, is this actually better? And we analyze very carefully what are our wins, what are our losses, what are the things that are approximately the same. And we believe that the changes that we make, that every time we launch a ranking refinement, that it is going to answer our users' questions better than it did before, based on the data that we have. But at the same time, we are also very conscious that people's perception of what is better makes things difficult to accurately assess what might actually truly be better. So we're also refining our measurement process all the time.
Thank you.
So we are trying to be conscious. Yes?
It seems like when you look at universal search and how like the one bonds start to appear in certain search results, it seems like it happens with more broad-based keyword set, and as I get more refined, is there any plans, or is that like a true assumption, or if not, or if it is a plan to kind of try to integrate things like video, or maybe image results, or something of that nature, into the more refined query types?
So we are committed to providing, sorry, I didn't get the question. The question was, it seems like the one boxes generally show up on more generic terms. And what is the plan to try to make that content show up on more long-tail queries, like more of the detailed queries? And I'm kind of sensitive on the question, because I work on book search, and we largely show up on those long-tail queries. And so I actually think it's really important to highlight there that there's a difference between one box, or one box, as we call the plural of one boxes, and universal properties. So there's some things that are pure universal. So book search is purely one. It can be in any position. It uses fluid ranking, and then there are one boxes that appear at the top of the page, the middle of the page, and the bottom of the page. And we're towards having those peer rankings for all universal properties. And we're also moving towards having more sensitive and broader one boxes. So the fact that